Hello everybody, Magnus here, and welcome back to Factorio. So, in the last video, I remember very clearly that I forgot to end the video. And these are coming out in bursts, I did not notice that. We have a nice little system going on here, too. Seriously, this is all synchronized. Seeker. They're all seeking out something, yep, totally, that's how they work. So we have that there. Oh, wait. I'm funny. I am just very funny. An oil refinery which requires stone. Speaking of which, I do not need walls anymore. So, oh yeah, I forget what past me does in his free time. And by that I mean I decided I did not need walls a long time ago, so I stopped making them. Well, okay, now I can make a refinery. Okay, I just need steel. Kind of on the edge in terms of steel supply, but I say that as I grab like a whole stack of steel, but still, I usually have like hundreds of steel in a chest at a time, so I would like to have some more steel. So, could I please have some more steel? That would be really nice. So this entire area down here is probably going to be for... Wait. Okay. Huge decision here. And this is probably going to be our main assembly area, and we'll need a lot of room for blue science when we get that. Okay, I should probably just say this before I go on any further, because I'm pretty sure I'm going to just chicken out and end the series. I always progress through the game, usually on my own, pretty quickly. And by that I mean I take days to get anything done, because I'm just that great with automating things, but when I do happen to reach the point where blue science becomes available, and... Alt. Okay, so anything that really steps in that area is just... Okay, pollution is unstable, that's what I've learned today. Is that us? I think that's us, but... When I do actually reach the point where I get blue science, especially when I don't have green science automated, which I've never had before, so I don't know how I'm going to act when I reach blue science now, but I usually tend to just give up because, well, I'll try to show you really quickly. So, yeah. Blue science requires a lot of automation just to get the bare components for it. As you can see, and just looking at it now, it just kind of scares me a little bit, just how much automation that's gonna take. Yes, low hum, I hear you. Truck driving by, I hope. Who knows, maybe it's Cthulhu coming to steal my soul. It's not soul, it's soul. But that's a lot of science packs. I mean, I know it has nothing on the rocket silo, but still, that's a lot for... What does it even do? I know it's a mod, but what does it even do? Okay, 10 damage plus 1 physical. So, no. Okay, yeah, I can kind of see how that would be a pretty good bullet. What do you even need to make it? I know I'm nowhere near that, but still. Oh yeah, you need like full out bullet damage and bullet shooting speed. That is also going to be a headache to make mass production. Where was I? Oh yeah, I forgot. I was waiting for these to build. The ultimate question. Where do I put it? The ultimate question is, what do I do with all the power I have? Because that is, again, at an all-time low here. This is, of course, going to spin fast constantly, because I gave it its own personal power source. So that way I'll constantly be scanning the map. I'll just place down one for now. And now I just need one more of those. And we should be good. So you do that with that. You'll do that with that. There. That should be enough. Okay, I forget. Because I wanted to make that. I'm not going to hate myself too much, though, because I pretty much did want to make that. I just wasn't ready to make it. Okay. This is gonna be a nightmare to produce. No. Don't question what I'm doing here. Please, because I won't have an answer right away. Okay. Have them there. One. That'll overlap. Again, don't question what I'm doing. If I just move this down one, then we should be good. That's done. That is a very good thing. Okay. Research that. Oh, yeah, we have quite a bit, so. I just need to power all these, and that should be. I just get. That should be it. Oh, my power lines are so unorganized, and the problem is I know how to fix them. I'm just too lazy to do it. So. Let's actually get this thing connected. We need a lot of underground pipes. Okay, so. One more. Okay. This is gonna take a lot of setup. Sorry if I'm being a bit quiet here. And now I'm pretty much cut power off from everything over here. And that's done. In the meantime, I'm gonna actually work to get a car. Okay, that should be producing. Okay, so the plan here currently, oil comes in from this way. We produce it here, and well, refine it here, and we turn it into actual fuel here. The fuel will come out eventually. Anytime now. Anytime now would be really nice for the demonstration. Thank you. It's brought along these conveyor belts. And picked up here. So there's a lot of storage over here. But just in case, I'm going to be making an area where we'll burn any excess fuel. Which, knowing solid fuel, that will take a while to burn it off. I don't know if it produces a lot of pollution, but it takes a while to burn it off. I would assume it produces less pollution than coal because, well, just read up on how much pollution coal would produce compared to solid fuel. It's a lot. But, or at least it's more, it produces more visible pollution. Which I guess the aliens really don't care if it's visible or not, they just care if they can smell it. And they have very good noses, so I probably sound like gibberish right now. Okay, so I did get some worm pods, if you haven't noticed, because I was looking at the nano bullets for a whole, I don't even know how long. I do not trust that window behind me. Okay, bring it in a bit more. No, wait. Better idea. So much coal. Now, if I could set this up right. And I'm pretty sure some people are wondering, like, why are you using burner inserters? Burner inserters are the worst. You are right, they are. I use them because they actually help with the coal overflow, which I actually really like. They actually will self-insert coal in them, and that's why I use them for everything that has to do with fuel. But just because I know this thing won't eat up all the stuff I'm producing. Oh, you are. Ew. Get that fixed. We do not. Okay, I need to stop and get some more coal, which we won't be using much longer if my plan actually works out, which it probably won't. Ooh, how did. I'm gonna assume you handled it. I just saw an attack happen down by the steel production area. Now we're gonna have these conveyor belts go way out here. Oh, wow, for the first time in forever, we have run out of conveyor belts. This is actually gonna be really good for our conveyor belt overflow. so many overflows. That's something I never thought I'd have to deal with in this game, I'm gonna be honest. Okay, that is, again, so many overflows. How is our inserter overflow going? Where is our inserter overflow? I'm assuming. Okay, so that makes inserters. Oh, this is our inserter overflow. It's an overflow. I'll give it that. It is, in fact, an overflow. We are currently overflowing with inserters. Okay. This is going to be a lot of things. Must all be one space in between each other. Okay. No. Bad inserter. Don't make it uneven. No. Bad placement skills. Don't make it uneven. Now we're gonna need to make a load of. We don't have enough coal. Ooh, how's our solid fuel? I'll have to check on that. Meanwhile, in the meantime, I'm gonna get coal. I will fuel all of you when I return from my trip to the place where we're going to dispose all of the stuff I could easily just put in you right now to burn all the stuff that you need to burn. Okay, that was a very long and unnecessary joke. Down the row of inserters. We could. Okay, yeah. I see the problem here. Yeah, we're gonna be doing this for a while. Twenty-nine torches. That's probably not gonna be enough. Oh, that wasn't a nice thing to see on the mini-map. Okay, I think we just got swarmed, but I'm probably going to end the video here. I'm going to try to place down as many of these things as I can. No, bad torch. This is going to produce so much pollution. No, bad torch. Is 29 all we need? No, we need four more. Okay, so this will be the area where all the stuff is burned. If that's not already obvious. Okay, flamethrower is done. We'll probably do that in the next episode I make. Which may not be going out for a while, I don't know. I would build a wall around here, but this honestly isn't a very important place. It's literally just for access stuff. I could do something cool where it, like, loops back around. If if there's so much fuel that I can't burn this, but if it's already burning this, I think it's safe to assume that I have more fuel than I know what to do with. The only really important things here are the turrets. So I'm going to actually wall those off. Because those are pretty, well, by expensive I mean they take up a lot of time to make, and I don't like losing them because of that. Oh yeah, this area is just cooking pollution. Why is there just random worms right there? Sorry, just why? I have to ask, why? Okay, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video, and bye.